हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड डिजिटल पेमेंट्स. क्लियर? नाउ सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. सर, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू वी मीन बाय डिजिटल पेमेंट्स? सर, इफ आई टेल यू इन सिंपल वर्ड्स, सर, डिजिटल पेमेंट मीन्स पेमेंट. क्लियर? पेमेंट थ्रू ऑनलाइन मोड. क्लियर? Payment through online mode is called what? Payment through online mode is called as what? It is called as digital payment. Sir, in digital payments, there is no cash involved. There is no cash involved. Clear? Sir, these are also called as digital payments are also called as electronic payment. Clear? Electronic payments. They are also called as what? Sir, they are also called as electronic payments. Clear? So whenever I am paying money to you and you are receiving money from me in an online mode, in an online environment where there is no cash involved, that is called what? That is called as digital payments. Sir, digital payments are also called as what? They are electronic payments. Sir, remember one thing. Digital payments are completely online. Completely online. Sir, what do I mean by completely online? Sir, receiver is also receiving it through an online mode. Payer is also paying through an online mode. Clear? Nowadays, even government is encouraging digital payments only because of this corona issue. Because of corona issue, the government has already instructed many people to use online payment or digital payment wherein hard cash should not be involved. Clear? Now, let us see the multiple types of digital payments. Clear? Let us see multiple types of digital payments. Now, sir, let us divide this concept into two parts. Let us divide these types of digital payments into two parts. One is the old methods of transferring the payment online, and second one is the new methods of transferring the payment online. Clear? With this, it becomes very easy for you to remember. Now, in old methods, the first method what we have is cards. Clear? Cards. In old method, the first method we are having is cards. I hope everyone knows cards. Sir, there are two types of cards. Clear? There are two types of cards. One is debit card, the other is credit card. Simple. There are two types of cards. One is debit card and the second one is credit card. Clear? So cards, basically, since the time ATM cards were issued, maybe long back in 10-11 years back, from that point of time only public is using debit cards and credit cards. That is why what I have done, I have kept this in old methods. Clear? So there are two types of cards. One is debit card and second credit card. Clear? Sir, the second type of method is net banking. Clear? Net banking, which is also called as what? Internet banking. Clear? Sir, this is also many people are using as of now. Many people are still using internet banking or net banking to transfer the money. Here, what will happen? In internet banking, what will happen? User has to log in. Clear? User has to log in to bank's website to transfer funds. Clear? To transfer funds. Sir, in addition to transfer funds, there are many options available. Sir, I can check my balance. Clear? I can check my balance. I can add a pay. I can transfer the money. I can receive the money. There are many things available in net banking. Let us say, for example, so what you have to do is for net banking, first thing, go to, let us say, I'll go to ICICI Bank. Clear? ICICIbank.com. Clear? Here, internet banking, mein what we have, see here there is an option available for me to log in. I need to log in. I need to log in here, or if I am a new user, what I need to do? I need to register. Once I click on login, clear? Once I click on login, then what will happen? I need to enter my user ID and password. I can access my internet banking either using the user ID, or I can access my internet banking either using my registered mobile number and OTP. Using a combination of mobile phone number and OTP or user ID and password, I need to log in. Sir, after login, what I can do? After logging, I can transfer the funds to a concerned person. This is also one of the old methods of transferring what? The money, or you can say the old methods of using digital payments. Clear? Next. One more method what we have is in the old methods, what I can say in the old methods is mobile wallets. Clear? Mobile wallets, or what I can say is digital wallets. Clear? Digital wallet. Clear? Digital wallet. Mobile wallet or digital wallet. Mobile wallet or digital wallet. Sir, what will happen in mobile wallet or digital wallet? What will happen in a mobile wallet or a digital wallet? It's just like a normal wallet, wherein what I can do, I can transfer the money online and from which I can make a payment. Let us say what will happen here is user will transfer money to an e-wallet. Clear? I repeat. In mobile wallets or digital wallets, what will happen? They are also called as electronic wallets. User will transfer money from bank account. Clear? User will transfer money from bank account to e-wallet. From e-wallet, payment will be made. Simple. From e-wallet, payment will be made. So the biggest problem in this mobile wallet is that first user needs to transfer the money from his or her bank account to wallet. From wallet, we need to make a payment. Sir, there are many examples. You can see there are many examples of wallets. Clear? E-wallets. Clear? There are many examples of e-wallets what you can take here. Clear? First one what we have is payments. Clear? First one what we have here is Paytm. Clear? First example here we have is Paytm. Then we have Oxygen wallet. Clear? Oxygen wallet. First one we have is Paytm. Second one is Oxygen wallet. Then we have PhonePe. Clear? PhonePe. These are three examples, or you can say Airtel money. These are some 3-4 examples of very popular e-wallets. But sir, biggest problem here, as I already told you, what people face is, first thing is that as a user, first what I need to do, I need to transfer money from my bank account to e-wallet. From e-wallet, I need to make a payment. Clear? From e-wallet, I need to make a payment. Clear? This is nothing but your digital wallet. Clear? Now let us write the answer for this one. Point number A. Sir, what is a digital wallet? It is a virtual version of physical wallet, right? Physical wallet. It is a virtual version of physical wallet. I hope everyone agrees. It's not physical, it is only virtual. Virtual means online or electronic. Next. User can store money and use whenever required. So whenever I want to transfer the money, I can transfer. Whenever I want to withdraw the money, I can withdraw. Sir, here transfer of money is easy. From my bank account, if I want to transfer money to Paytm, it's very easy, no problem, no charges. But sir, problem here is, if I want to retransfer the money from my Paytm account to my bank account, some charges will be there. That is why many people do not use this type of, very rarely that they use e-wallets nowadays. Clear? But sir, cashback offers are given to attract users. Clear? cashback offers are given to attract what? Users. I can use it for multiple purpose. I can recharge my mobile phone. Clear? I can recharge my mobile phone. What I can do? Sir, I can pay my electricity bill. I can pay my telephone bill. Anything you can do nowadays with the help of what? E-wallet. Let us say you go to paytm.com and see here. I think net is a bit slow. Just a second. Let it load. Till that time, what we'll do? Till that time, we'll continue here. Clear? Next two. Now let us come back to new method. Sir, there were many problems with old method. That is why the new methods of transfer have been launched. In the new methods, let us take first one what we have in our new methods. First one what we have in our new methods is IMPS. I repeat, the first new method what we have is IMPS. Sir, what do we mean by IMPS? Immediate payment service. IMPS stands for what, sir? Sir, IMPS stands for immediate payment service. Immediate payment service. Clear? I repeat, IMPS stands for what, sir? Sir, IMPS stands for immediate payment service. Clear? Immediately what will happen? I can transfer the funds. I repeat, in IMPS what will happen? I can transfer the funds within seconds. Clear? No. But sir, problem in IMPS is, see, normally what happens is in NEFT or RTGS, the problem with NEFT or RTGS is I can transfer funds only during business hours. I repeat, when we are using NEFT or RTGS, nowadays NEFT also some rules have changed, but normally what happens is in NEFT and RTGS, it will take some time to transfer the money. Let us say 1 hour, 2 hour or 3 hours, or it may go in 3-4 hours also, transfer may happen. But in case of IMPS, sir, immediately payment will be transferred. Sir, immediately money will be debited from my account and money will be credited in your account. Immediate debit and credit will happen in simultaneously in accounts. That is why the name has come to this technology called IMPS. Sir, IMPS I can do from ATM also. I can do from my mobile phone also. Clear? I can use internet banking also. Clear? I can use internet banking also. But sir, problem with IMPS, sir, lot of data is required to transfer money using IMPS. Let us take a simple example. If I want to transfer money from you, I need your name, I need your bank account number, I need your IFSC code, clear? IFSC code. Then I need your clear? Name is required, bank account number is required, IFSC code is required, branch name is required, branch name or area is required. So there is lot of data required to transfer money from my bank account to your bank account using IMPS. But it is still better than compared to what? NEFT and RTGS. Lot better than compared to NEFT and RTGS. Why, sir? Because NEFT and RTGS mein kya hota? It will take lot of time for me to transfer the money. 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, lot of time it will take. But in IMPS, even though lot of data is required, immediately I can transfer the money from my bank account to your bank account. But sir, in order to overcome problem of IMPS, new technology called Unified Payment Interface was launched. Unified Payment Interface. In popularly which is known as UPI was launched. Clear? UPI was launched. This is the new technology wherein I can transfer the money from my bank account to your bank account just by using the mobile phone number. I will be able to transfer the money from one bank account to another bank account. Clear? But sir, in UPI, to transfer funds in UPI, UPI ID is required. UPI ID is required. Sir, how many people should have UPI ID? Sir, sender also should have, receiver also should have. I repeat, sender should also have UPI ID, receiver should also have the UPI ID. Clear? Both sender and receiver should have what? UPI ID. Then only this is possible. Clear? Then only it is possible. Normally what happens is, sir, I have multiple bank accounts, 5-6 bank accounts I have. Clear? I have 5-6 bank accounts. But sir, problem, individually, if I want to log into my internet banking account, it may take a lot of time. I may remember my bank account details, I may not remember my bank account details. So what will I do? This UPI has made my job easier. I just login, I just create my UPI ID. I just create my UPI ID by giving the details required for it. And immediately all the bank accounts linked to my mobile phone number will be displayed. Select the bank account and transfer the funds from wherever you want. So in simple words, UPI, what will UPI do? UPI does not require name, bank account number, IFSC code, branch number. All this headache is not required in UPI. Sir, what is required in UPI? In UPI is required is UPI ID. It integrates what? It integrates multiple bank accounts. It integrates multiple bank accounts with same UPI ID. So in simple words, I have three bank accounts. ICICI. I have Axis Bank. Clear? I also have HDFC. In that case, what happens? I don't need bank account details for all these three. I don't need bank account details, login ID and password for these three bank accounts. What I need? I just need a mobile phone number which is connected to this particular bank account. Automatically, UPI ID will be generated. Clear? There are thousands of apps nowadays which are using UPI. It is a technology developed by whom? Can you tell me, sir, who developed this technology? Can any student tell me who developed this technology? Very good. Sir, UPI was developed by whom? UPI was developed by NPCI. NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India. It was developed by whom? Sir, it was developed by NCPI. Remember one thing, sir, UPI is not an app. UPI is not an app. It is a technology which is used by multiple apps. Now let us say we have Google Pay. Clear? Google Pay uses, clear? Google Pay is there. Then we have Phone Pay, we have. Sir, today this fellow, what is this? Paytm also uses, clear? Paytm or Truecaller. So there are multiple apps which are now using a technology called what? UPI. This technology was developed by whom? So this technology was developed in India by NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India. Remember one thing, very important for multiple choice questions. Tell me, sir, is UPI a technology or an app? Sir, it is a technology which is used by an app. Simple. It is a technology which is used by multiple apps. Clear? Next. After what we have IMPS and UPI, we have something called one more new technology called BHIM. Bharat Interface for Money. Clear? Bharat Interface for Money. BHIM. Bharat Interface for Money. Not Chota BHIM or Bada BHIM. It's BHIM. Clear? BHIM. Bharat Interface for Money. Sir, this is an app. Again, remember one thing. Sir, this is an app developed by. Developed again by whom? Sir, NPCI. It is an app developed by NPCI. I repeat, it is an app developed by NPCI using UPI technology. Which technology? UPI technology. Sir, IMPS also transfers money. UPI also transfers money. Sir, Bheem also transfers money. So then what is the difference? Sir, IMPS, sir, I repeat, IMPS is a technology where internet banking is required and which requires multiple details like name, bank account number, IFSC code, branch name, etc., etc. to be transferred. But sir, UPI mein, sir, in UPI, all this headache is not required. I need to generate a UPI ID. And sir, what is Bheem? Sir, UPI is a technology. I repeat, UPI is a technology. And Bheem is an app created to use that technology. I repeat, UPI is a technology. And Bheem is an application developed by MPCI to use that technology called UPI. So there is no separate app for UPI, but there is a separate app for Bheem. And sir, what is the difference? Then again, sir, this digital wallet. Again, the headache. Sir, in UPI, I need not transfer money to Google Pay. I repeat, in UPI, I can directly transfer the money from my bank account to your bank account. But sir, in digital wallet, first from my bank account, I have to transfer money to my digital wallet. From digital wallet, I need to transfer money to your digital wallet or bank account. Clear? Next, it is an app developed by NPCI. Using which technology, sir? Using UPI technology. Sir, what will it do? It will help in transfer of funds. Simple. It will help in what? So transfer of funds. Using what? Using mobile app. Using what? Sir, mobile app. Using what app? Sir, using a mobile app. Simple. And next technology, clear? Next technology we have AEPS. Sir, Aadhaar enabled payment service. Aadhaar enabled payment service, AEPS. Sir, this technology has not yet been launched. Sir, this technology is not yet launched. Sir, this technology not yet launched. It might be launched very soon. Normally what we do is whenever we want to purchase something through debit card or credit card, we go to the particular machine, and what we do, we swipe our card, right? After going into a particular machine, we swipe our card. Nowadays, rather than swiping the card, now what we can do is, you can go, I can just show you just a second. I think my net is not working properly. Just hold on for a second. Clear? Just let me show you once. Yeah. I think it should be better now. Paytm. See, as I already told you, by using digital wallet, what I can do, I can recharge, I can pay my electricity bill, I can play games also, I can pay my DTH bill, I can book train tickets, multiple things I can do using digital wallets. Clear? Now, one more thing, Google, let us go POS machine. Clear? POS machine. Normally we call it as card swiping machine, right? So this is your normally what we do. What we do normally is here what we do, we insert the card, we enter the PIN number, and the transaction will be complete. Normally in debit card or credit card, what do? Sir, we insert the card or we wave the card. If it is a RFID card, we just wave the card nearby the machine and enter the PIN number, and transaction is complete. Sir, this headache will not be required now. This headache will not be required now with the help of AEPS. Sir, in AEPS, what will happen? In AEPS, what we have to do is just enter here in AEPS. Just enter what? Sir, here in this machine, what we have to do? Enter Aadhaar card number. In this machine, what we have to do? Enter Aadhaar number. Clear? Aadhaar card number. Just enter the Aadhaar card number, and on clear, after entering the Aadhaar card number, press this green button. Clear? Once the technology is launched, what you have to do, sir, enter your Aadhaar card number and press on this green button. Then what happens? Immediately OTP will come to the mobile phone number. Immediately what will happen? OTP will come to mobile phone number which is registered with your Aadhaar card. Clear? Normally when you register for Aadhaar card, you have to give your phone number. So once you enter your Aadhaar card number and press on this green button, immediately OTP will come to the mobile phone. Sir, which mobile phone? The mobile phone number which you have registered with Aadhaar data. Clear? Then what you have to do? Enter the OTP, press the green button again, transaction is complete. So simple now. So rather than carrying my debit cards, credit cards and all, I repeat, rather than carrying my debit cards, credit cards, remembering so many pins and all, that headache itself will be gone. Why? Sir, nowadays it is mandatory to link Aadhaar cards with your bank account. So once this technology is launched, what will happen? Aadhaar card number you have to enter to transfer funds. Clear? Uses what? Uses Aadhaar and OTP to transfer what? Transfer funds. Clear? Transfer funds. Simple. So, but problem here, your Aadhaar card, it is mandatory to register your Aadhaar card number with whom? Point number one, your Aadhaar card should be registered with the bank. And second, your mobile phone number should be registered with Aadhaar department. Then only this will work. Clear? And the last type of technology is unstructured. Clear? Unstructured supplementary service data. In short, USSD. Sir, now let us say I don't have a smartphone. I don't have internet. Clear? I repeat, the situation is like this. Sir, I don't have a smartphone and I don't have internet. Can I transfer funds in this situation? I repeat, can I transfer the funds in a situation where I have no smartphone, I have no internet? Yes. Sir, even nowadays with the technology called USSD, it is possible to transfer funds with a phone without internet or without a smartphone, also with a normal dabba or a feature phone. Clear? So this technology does not require what? A smartphone. Clear? This technology does not require what? A smartphone or what? An internet connection. Clear? Internet connection to transfer funds. Sir, how is it possible that, without internet, without smartphone, I will be able to transfer my money? Yes, that is possible. So go to your keypad, type, clear, what you have to do? Simple, *99#, clear, *99#. Using this number called *99#, I will be able to send or receive the money or check balance, change my, sir, whatever you are able to do with a normal smartphone for using UPI and all, I will be able to do without a smartphone using what? A technology called USSD. Clear? So I hope everything is clear. Sir, what is a digital payment then? Sir, payment made online. It is also called what? Electronic payment. Any cash is involved? No. Is it completely online? Yes. Very good. Simple. Sir, how many types of digital payments are there? 3 we have studied in old methods, and how many? Sir, 5 we have studied in new methods. So total 8. In old methods, first one we have seen is cards. How many types of cards are there, sir? 2 types, debit card and credit card. In net banking, what will happen? User has to log in to the bank's website, enter user ID, password, and then transfer the funds. Sir, how many options are available in internet banking? Sir, there are 3 options available basically for anyone in internet banking. Sir, can someone tell what are those? There are 3 options available under internet banking to transfer money. One is IMPS, the other is NEFT, and last one is RTGS. Then I have mobile wallet also. Example, Paytm, Oxygen Wallet, PhonePay, Airtel Money, etc. But sir, problem with mobile wallet or digital wallet, or you can say e-wallet. Problem here. I need to first transfer the money from my bank account to wallet. From wallet, I need to make a payment. That is the biggest problem. So in order to overcome this problem, what was introduced? UPI. UPI may, can I transfer funds? Yes. By using your bank details? No. But problem here, sender also should have UPI ID, receiver also should have UPI ID. Sir, who introduced UPI in India? NPCI, National Payments Corporation of India. Clear? Is it an app or a technology? Sir, it is a technology, not an app. Example, Google Pay uses this technology, Phone Pay uses, Paytm uses, Truecaller. So almost every app which is allowing you to transfer money uses a technology called UPI. Sir, in order to use this technology, government has developed its own app called what? Bheem, Bharat Interface for Money. So Bheem is an app which uses a technology called UPI. And then in order to transfer money through Aadhaar card, we need to use called APS. This technology is not yet finalized as of now. Sir, in order to transfer the money without any smartphone or without internet, I need USSD by dialing a number called *99#. And I also have one more method called what? IMPS, Immediate Payment Service. Sir, in NEFT and RTGS, what will happen? In NEFT and RTGS, to transfer the money, it takes lot of time, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours sometimes. So in order to ensure that there is no delay, immediate payment system was introduced, wherein immediately money will get debited from my account and credited to your account, but some minimum charge, some 6-7 rupees they'll charge. From bank to bank it differs. So to transfer money through IMPS, what do I need to do? I need to add you as a payee, for which I need your bank name, bank account details, IFSC code, branch name, area, etc, etc. Clear? So I hope the concept of digital payment is clear. Sir, advantages and disadvantages of digital payment we will cover in next class. That is our next video. Clear?